All right, if we zoom in a little bit more and talk about SCADAS XS, again, intended really just to be primarily noise and vibration types of measurements. Very portable system. You can see the size here sitting on the dash. This is smaller than the 9-inch tablet that she's using to run the system. Very flexible in the way the SCADAS XS works. I can pre-program it such that I'm literally going to start and stop it by hitting this little record button. I could have it set up to trigger, then when I hit record, it waits for trigger, then it measures, so it can be kind of an automatic mode. Most of our customers, though, really enjoy the Android tablet application, the Scope app per se, where I can get all different kinds of views, overall levels, the levels for a given channel. I can change configurations, calibrate things, look at waterfalls, color maps, all while I'm running that SCADAS XS hardware. Think of it as a very fancy remote control because I'm looking at the data, but it's all being stored in a memory device inside the SCADAS XS. So all that's stored to a micro SD card, and you can then either copy it through the USB cable to a host computer to analyze it, or pop the card out and put it in and just copy the files off that way or analyze them directly. And this front end can also work as a direct operation to hooked up to a Windows PC running Simcenter Test Lab software. It's just a straight front end, just like you would a SCADAS mobile or a SCADAS lab. One comment though on channel counts though, because this sometimes confuses people and it's different than the way a lot of our competitors count channels, in that we say 6 or 12 channel plus, and that's because if we look at these connectors over here for a moment, let me zoom in real quick. You'll notice that on the left, there's one big Leno connector. It has HS above, a little hard to see in the slide maybe, but that's for a headset. So there's a dedicated 2-channel binaural headset input. Those 2 channels are in addition to the regular measurement channels. The next 4 larger Leno connectors are 3-channel inputs for voltage, ICP, AC/DC measurements. So like in this case, the 3 to the right, you can see they have kind of the tan cable where it splits out into 3 different B and C's. So that's how I get 3 channels into that one plug. So that's your 12 channels. If it's a 12-channel system, 1, 2, 3, 4 of those plugs, 3 channels each. A 6-channel version only has the sockets for the first 2. A little bit cheaper, obviously. It doesn't have all the electronics inside that a 12-channel does. But beyond those 6 or 12 channels and beyond the 2 channels of the headset, there's also GPS antenna input. There's an input for a digital binaural head that we can decode that data stream from right left ears directly. There's a CAN bus input where I can plug in a data stream, a digital data stream from a vehicle, including CAN-FD and the later model of the SCADAS XS. And then finally, a dual tachometer input where I can have up to 2 different tacho signals being measured on the XS as well. So we're talking the 6 or 12 plus 2 headset, plus 2 binaural head, plus the GPS, plus the 2 tacho, plus CAN bus, all in that one unit. Pretty nice system. It does sample at a max of 51.2 kilohertz. So we're talking full audio bandwidth there to get you 20 kilohertz bandwidth. So not as fast as some of the SCADAS mobile and lab cards, but generally covers 95% of the noise and vibration measurements that our customers generally want to do.